I've trained more world champs than anyone else in boxing history. In 66 seconds, Roberto Duran changed my life.
Well, I trained and trained and trained until I almost broke. You know, I mean, I was training 4 hours a day for over 8 months before we shot. It was very important for me to become a boxer on my own and to learn how to fight before I even try to learn Duran's movements and combinations.
Well, I'm actually very proud of Edgar because from the moment I first met him, he basically knew nothing about boxing. He told me, I'm an actor, I'm not a boxer. I'm like, well, I'm an actor and I know how to fight. And it just so happened that I'm Duran's son, so let's work this out. So we began training and he's training with my brother as well.
When you talk about the magic of a film, it first starts with the cast of characters. And then you get to the magic of Edgar Ramirez.
So the first one is this, it's one. And
Edgar really does do the work to make sure that there are no accidents so that we didn't hurt each other, but could act out the moment and really live in the method of it.
And then you get me.
I really do think this is a special labor of love for all of the people who are involved.
Edgar, he was training for months. I've never seen an actor doing such a big transformation.
There's a particular Panamanian way of boxing. It's very related to music and to salsa. I mean, there's a dance there that has to do with the African Caribbean culture and the music. You could train to music, and actually I did, and so did Duran. There's something that changes in the way you move, and that was something that was very important to me to understand and to integrate and to allow it to become my second skin, my second nature.
I really wanted to help him with the training. I was walking on his abs at one point while he was stretching. It was a beautiful process, how his body changed. People would see him in the ring or on the street, and they were just yelling at him, oh, that's exactly how Duran looks.
I was trained by the best in every field. I even had to learn, you know, how to play congas for the film because he's a great conga player. When you think that you cannot go any further, then they push you because you can. That is something that you learn. So like you break through it and then you get emotionally and physically to places that you never imagined that you could enter. It was a very deep and amazing transformation for me. It was more than a film. It was a life experience. It was a life-altering experience for me. And I feel very privileged to have had the opportunity to portray one of the most legendary Latin American boxers in the history of the sport.
I've trained more world champs than anyone else in boxing history. I haven't stepped into a ring for more than a decade. In 66 seconds, Roberto Duran changed my life.
I want you to meet the best trainer in the history of boxing, Rey Arcel.
I don't even know if that's from America.
I know. He grew up in the streets, fought everything, hating everybody. He's wild.
You can help him, Rey.
You can make him a champ.
Slow down and go. You can and no comprende. Turn the right hand over. Go, 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 go.
Duran should fight no one but me.
I don't lose.
You put God in the ring and I will beat him.
And now, Sugar Ray Leonard.
Circles around you. Fight!
This is inexplicable.
I work all my life. I didn't have any food when I was a kid. I'm hungry. I don't want to be hungry anymore.
no mas.
He needs to come back.
Roberto Duran, the man with the hands of stone.
We are in for a serious fight.
That's it. That's it.
Action movie fans, 2016 is a great year for action movies. Some great titles have already been released, but there are still some awesome titles to come. The Magnificent Seven remake starring Denzel Washington, Chris Pratt, Ethan Hawke, Matt Bomer, about desperate townspeople who employ protection from seven outlaws, bounty hunters, gamblers, and hired guns. The next Jack Reacher installment, Never Go Back, starring Tom Cruise, which sees Reacher heading back to his old military base in Virginia and being charged with transgressions he can't remember. So in true Reacher style, he gets to the bottom of it with cunning and sometimes brute force. Ethan Hawke and John Travolta star in A Valley of Violence, about a mysterious drifter who finds himself in a once popular mining town which is controlled by a brash group of misfits and nitwits. So, do you think you'll be going to see any of these? If so, which one? Let me know in the comments below and remember to subscribe to our channel for all the best action movie trailer releases.